Lindy just launched new features that make it the cursor of AI agent. In this video, I'm going to show you real use cases of what that means and how you can utilize this yourself. There are three key unlocks: being able to type a task and have Lindy create an AI agent for you without having to deal with the drag and drop interface of Lindy. There's Autopilot, where Lindy can actually access a virtual computer. So whatever tasks a human can do, Lindy can now do it as well without needing API access. And there's also team features, so you can build an AI agent and share it with your entire organization. Thank you so much to Lindy for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description to get your own Lindy account for free and build your own AI agents alongside me. Let's jump in. Here we are on the Lindy homepage, and there's a few suggested tasks that they have, so we're gonna test those out and see how well they can do. Let's start with an outbound sales call. By clicking on this button, Lindy is going to write a prompt for us. So it is, "I want an agent to call leads, add into a spreadsheet, pitch them my product, and help them book a sales call. Before the call begins, it should check my calendar for availability and ask the lead for their email address before booking the meeting." So let's go ahead and send this away, and let's see how this Lindy AI agent actually works. So here on the middle of the screen, we can see the agent is responding to our initial request, and it's basically saying it needs us to go to the flow editor. It's going to guide us to set up the components that it needs, such as spreadsheet integration, phone calling capabilities, calendar integration. Which makes sense. So it's essentially going to ask me for permission to have access to these services. So let's click redirect to flow editor. So now on the left side, the AI agent is asking me what services I want to use. So for spreadsheet, let's say I want to use Google Sheets. I'll say I'm good with Lindy's built-in phone capabilities. Let's use Google Calendar. For communication, we can say email notifications work. And the product and service, let's say it is a cleaning service for restaurants. Spreadsheet structure, why don't we say you decide? Okay, so we'll send that off and let's see what we get back. So now the agent is basically summarizing what the workflow could be. So I'm gonna say yes, that looks right. And now the Lindy agent is actually creating this workflow for us. And you can see in real time what it's doing. In just a second, you're going to see what Lindy was able to create. This is pretty cool. So we have the actual workflow that was created for us. And this would have taken me a lot of time to figure out. And even if I was brand new to Lindy, I wouldn't even know how to do this or how to get started. So we can see it has a trigger, it has an action of calling the lead. And then based on whether the lead was interested in the meeting or not, it's going to take action. So there's some configuration. And again, the AI is helping us go step by step through this process. So it's just asking me to connect my Google account. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So we connected our Google account. And now it's saying it needs to configure the remaining required fields, starting with Google Sheets actions. Okay, this is pretty cool. So it needs the Google Sheets URL, which I haven't created yet, but it's telling me the format that it needs, and it's suggesting the columns that it needs to be added. So let me do that real quick and give it a URL. So all I had to do was give it the URL of the Google Sheet, and now it is completing the configuration. So Lindy is saying this is fully configured. It's going to monitor the Google Sheet, and it's going to go through all of the steps that we talked about. And it's as simple as that. With just prompting with the Lindy agent, we were able to create our own AI agent that's going to perform a real-world task with us. And of course, this could be applied to many different types of AI agents, not just this one. So let's jump in and do one more real quick. We're back on the homepage and let's try out the customer support email prompt. So I want an agent that will monitor my support inbox and help answer customer support questions using a knowledge base. If the agent does not know the answer to the question, it should escalate the question via a Slack DM. So let's go ahead and send this off. And of course, you can modify, you can come up with your own prompt based on your own problems. So let's send that away. And again, similar to the last time, the agent is going to help us set up this entire workflow. And I'll zoom through a little bit faster this time so that you don't have to sit through as much of the AI agent asking questions. But I just want to show you what's possible. So let's jump to the final workflow right now. All right, and we are finished. So this is a little bit of a simpler workflow here, but the AI did it all for me, 100%. So it starts with the trigger. So it's going to check my inbox to see if I'm getting an email that needs a support answer. Then it's going to check to see if the knowledge base has the answer. So to do that, it's first going to search the knowledge base. Now, because in the setup, it asked if I had a knowledge base yet, and if I didn't have a knowledge base, it said it would put in basically like a placeholder, and then I could add the knowledge base. Because I don't have one yet, it just put this in as a placeholder to search the knowledge base. And the knowledge base is something that is built into Lindy. So right here, I can create one. It's as simple as just going down to the plus button. You can add a website, text, files, Google Drive. Any of this information can be the knowledge base. That's pretty cool that it has that built in. Then, if the knowledge base has the answer, it's going to just respond and reply. If it doesn't have the answer, it's going to send me an escalation email, basically giving me the information and saying that it doesn't have the answer. Pretty cool that it did all of this on its own. So this was completely done with the AI agent with this automated workflow. And again, because of the team features on Lindy, you can create this and then anyone on your team can access it. And it can be an AI agent that works across your team. All right, now in this task, what we're going to do is test out the Autopilot feature where it can actually use a remote computer and go on its own browser and basically take action based on that. So what I want to do is build out this automation. Let's say I own a mattress company and I want to monitor a competitor. So I want to monitor Casper.com. They create mattresses. For any price changes using computer use, every day, please list the prices in a Google Sheet. So a specific task and maybe something that would be useful to someone who runs an e-commerce mattress company, or you can think about how this might work for you to monitor competitors. So let's see how well it actually does to build this out. And it asks for some clarifying questions, what products, what Google Sheet it should use. What information should it be tracking and what time of day? So it gave it answers to that. And now it's basically just summarizing what I want it to do to make sure that it's doing everything that I asked for. So I'm going to say, yes, that is what I want. And then the next step should be for it to actually create that AI agent. In a second, I'm going to show you that final product. But first, the agent is going to build it on the left side and we can watch it in real time as it builds out our workflow. Okay, so we have our final workflow that the AI created for us. And while it seems simple, it's more complicated than it might seem to put together. And what it's actually completing for us is quite impressive. So first, just on a schedule every day at 9 a.m., it's going to run this trigger. So that's a cool thing that Lindy has the ability to do. Then it's going to start the computer. This is the autopilot that I talked about, where it can actually access a computer. Then it's basically has a complex AI workflow here. And it wrote this all out. It's navigating to Casper.com, extracting all mattress product names and current prices. It's creating or updating a Google Sheet called Casper Price Tracker with columns, product name, current price, and date, and adding the data as a new row. Now, the first time it does this, it's going to create a spreadsheet because it doesn't have it yet. Then it will append rows to that spreadsheet. So let's test this out to see if it actually works. For some reason, Casper.com is actually not loading right now for me, even outside of this. So I think something is wrong with Casper.com right now. So I'm going to use a different mattress website. Okay, so we're going to actually do Nectar instead. It's a different mattress company, very similar, but for some reason, like the Casper website is actually down right now. So now we're testing, and we can see on the right side, it's navigating to the Nectar Sleep website, which should actually work. And I can open it up to actually see it happening in real time. And there we go. So, yes, the Nectar Sleep website is not down. I don't know what's going on with Casper right now. But here, we should see the AI basically browsing this website and getting the data that we need. Now, remember, this is normally going to happen in the background. So, you're not going to have to watch it happen. It might do it a little bit slowly. But it's going to be happening in the background, just as if you hired an actual employee to go to Nectar Sleep and actually get these prices. So this is what it's doing right now. It's going to the mattress page here, and it is actually getting the data for us. All right, it finished it successfully. I can click and go into the actual spreadsheet, and I can see the product name, the current price, and the date. So pretty cool. And maybe something I could add in the future is current price or like discounted price, normal price, whatever, if I wanted to get this data however I wanted. But it was able to get all of this data successfully for me. So I hope that you
That's
enjoyed
great to
this
hear.
video and saw how cool it is that you can prompt to create an AI agent. In this last task, you saw how powerful Autopilot is, and that's something that Lindy has that I think is a little bit different from other tools. And then there's the team features of Lindy that allow you to create these agents and have them do tasks across your team that everyone has access to. Thank you again to Lindy for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description to try out Lindy for free and test out your own AI automations with Lindy's AI agents. Leave a comment below and let me know what you think of Lindy and if this is something that you would want to try yourself. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content just like this. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.